Good morning, girls. I'm 34 weeks. Yesterday was my 34-week doctor's appointment. I went in a little nervous because 2 weeks ago at my 32-week doctor's appointment, I was already 1 centimeter. I'm on my fourth baby, so very well could be dilating and not be in active labor. So yesterday I went to my appointment. I'm like, listen, I feel like I need to be rechecked. Kind of like, you know, a little discomfort. They recheck me and I'm 3 centimeters. What? So crazy. See, I still have my hospital band on. They send me next door to the hospital to just make sure I'm not in active labor, monitor me, and also they started me on a round of steroids, which will basically strengthen the baby's lungs. And so we did that. I was probably at the hospital for about 4 hours, was not in active labor, hadn't had any contractions. They gave me my first dose of steroids, and I go back today for my second dose of steroids. Basically, because this is my fourth baby, active labor probably doesn't even start until 5 or 6 centimeters. I'm just finding that out. My last pregnancy, I did go in to the hospital for like questions about fetal movement, and I was already 4 centimeters. So my history of pregnancies leading up to this fourth one is that my body does tend to start early labor at home without me actually knowing. Good thing and a bad thing, because I guess that leads to very quick labor and delivery. But I'm getting ready to take a shower. I have a lash appointment for Saturday. Are we gonna make it to Saturday? Are we gonna make it to Saturday? Someone tell me now. I don't know, but I'm getting ready to wash my hair and get it prepped for braids. I'm hoping I can get braids in before I go into labor. When am I going into labor? I feel so crazy. So anyway, baby is moving fine. Vitals are all good. When I go back today, they'll just like check vitals and do my last round of steroids. And then from there, I'm just home on baby watch until baby decides to come, which, what's your guess? I don't know. Let's just see, can we make it through these next appointments? And that is why we're here. That is why I'm making this vlog, is to see that I can make it to get some lashes on, because what is this? And if I can get my hair braided. Bojangles breakfast. So we're gonna eat breakfast real quick, head to the hospital. I'm hoping they get me in and out and just give me the shot. Maybe check my blood pressure, make sure we're good, and send me on my way. Seeing as though I already will probably be back whenever I go into labor. I'm trying to catch my lash tech said she could get me in at 2. Be great if I could catch her and get that out the way today, because I already don't have much time. We are headed up to do what we need to do at the hospital real quick, hoping to be in and out so I can wrap up with what I have to wrap up with and just be on baby watch.
Don't look at me. Don't look at me.
They have us set up, but we should still be in and out. I had my last steroid shot, and we're just monitoring baby, checking pulse, blood pressure. I should be able to get out of here in time for my lash appointment. One more blood pressure check, and then we should be good to go. So, this week monitor. Made it in time for the nail appointment. Getting my lashes done. Getting it out the way. And my pedicure. Thank God. Whew. Let's see. Yesterday, after doing my lashes and my toes, I just came home and decided to just sit down and relax for a bit. Just at this point, taking it one day at a time. Baby is still in the belly, so the closer we can get to 36 weeks, the better. I will be 35 weeks this weekend. I wanted to say the only thing I'm waiting on now, which I'm totally fine with going into labor and delivery with a head wrap if I have to, but I'm hoping I can get my hair appointment in on Sunday. Not Sunday, I have it on Wednesday. If I can make it to my hair appointment, then I'm really all set for labor and delivery. I did pack my hospital bag. There's a separate video that I posted it on my TikTok and Instagram, and I actually posted it as a short also. So if you want to see what I put in my hospital bag, I would check that video out. I definitely got like my postpartum stuff together that I do want to show you guys in here. So like, I have these that I'm gonna put in my Amazon storefront, but these are really good for breast pain because you can use them hot or cold, especially once your milk starts coming in. I got some more nursing pads. I have my maxi pads. I love the purple ones because they're super long. I have my Depends. I literally swear by Depends. In here, I got my pad sickles from Freedom Mom that are really good. Got my tux pads, this little perfect upside down Perry bottle, which was very helpful for me last time, so I'm gonna use it again this time. A lot of this stuff I am gonna put in my Amazon storefront, but for the most part I feel like I'm just on baby watch. I'm taking it easy. I'm gonna rest this weekend. I'll show you. I do have this little kit that I put together for the baby. So like diapers, wipes, which obviously I don't need this stuff at the hospital because the hospital gives you all of this, but like this is just to keep close by the bedside. So I set that up too. So again, just doing whatever prep that I can do on my end to make sure that I'm prepared and just taking it one day at a time. So I probably will not vlog this weekend, just trying to take it easy and keep baby baking inside as long as I can. But I will be back on to update you guys if I get in for my hair appointment before I go into labor. So stay tuned for that and I'll talk to you guys in a day or so. Do you know what today is? I'm gonna get my hair braided. Is my get my black bag out my closet, Serena. I need to pack some stuff.
Okay.
And I'm gonna pack some snacks.
I know, I stay on the floor on the couch.
Even huh? What? Oh, mommy's stomach is hurting. But I'm going to get my hair braided, no matter what.
Yeah.
Mommy, I'm gonna bring one for the road.
And one for this, like, here.
Serena, did you find my bag?
Yes.
Oh, thank you.
We don't know.
And are we gonna do like the baskets?
Know what I do?
What's wrong, Sia? I'm going to get my hair braided, and I've made it to 35 weeks. I will be 36 weeks this weekend, but I've made it to my hair appointment, and I know that was like the biggest thing, and so I'm just happy to be here. I'm just happy to be going to get my hair braided.
It came out during a time that women were such fans of hip hop, but we didn't necessarily see ourselves completely reflected in the music. It wasn't the typical R&B.
Are you gonna stay? This is not how you're gonna be. This is only your journey back to where you started from. I said, yeah, okay. So if I look at it that way, then all I gotta do is survive this.
She might do something with her mouth, like short.
So cute, I love it. It's the perfect length too. Well, what can I say? We've made it. Now that my hair is done, we can calmly and restfully wait for baby's arrival. My guess is that it will be a July baby. Today's the 28th of June, so, you know, I'm fine with any time after this as long as we have a healthy, safe labor and delivery. It's been a roller coaster of a week. The next time you guys hear from me will be my labor and delivery vlog. Thank you guys for watching, tuning in to this first vlog, but most importantly, the most exciting part of this entire pregnancy. So, have a good night. I will see y'all soon with a new baby. Bye, guys.